we go. I'm glad that took so long to load up, I suppose. Wait, the music's a bop. Wait a minute, why are my ears disappearing? That's not supposed to happen. There we go, I think it's pretty fixed, okay. Alright, anyways, is it showing up? Yes, it is. Okay. It's a bop. It's a bop, Your Honor. Alright, so, basically what we're playing... There's a voice? Anyways, return. Alright, so if you do not know what Light the Way is, it is a Luxium dating simulator made by. Let me pull up the tweet, give me a minute. I should really pull this stuff up beforehand, but no, I don't want to. Anyways, hold on. It is Light the Way, a Luxium dating simulator for Luxium's one-year anniversary. Currently, there is a demo out. That's what I'll be playing. You can download it on Simporiums-studios.itch.io. Go check out their tweet. It'll be there. You'll be fine. It's basically a fan-made Luxium visual novel brought to you by Simporium Studios. And I can already tell it's going to be absolutely amazing. I was trying to play on my phone, just like I tried to play Quiz Deluxe on my phone. Failed, obviously. Yeah. So I have to play on my computer once again. Petition to make more Luxium mobile-related game fan games. Please? Also, I'm reading Watashi something. I think that's Ao. Like, then Aomori. And then... No Hikari. I'm smart. Anyways. There's the about. Yep. The demo. We currently have the demo. Here's their Twitter. Oh, I didn't know they had TikTok. Instagram. They have a Facebook. The more you know. Yeah. See? Light the Way, Luxium Dating Sim is a lovingly crafted passion project by Simporium Studios. This fan project is dedicated to showcasing the mutual sentiment and fondness between Luxium and their fans with a lighthearted dating sim. More specifically, the demo of Light the Way is a gift to celebrate Luxium's first anniversary, as well as a teaser for the full game that will be coming in March 2023. Ooh. Credits for the demo are featured below this section. One and two. Ayo. I can't wait to play. I'm so excited because I put on my calendar when it would be. Like, counting down the days and stuff. We have settings. Not much to, like, yeah. Anyways, press help. Enter advances dialogue and activates the interface. Space advances dialogue without selecting choices. Arrow keys navigate the interface. Escape accesses the game menu. Control skips dialogue while held down. Tap toggles dialogue skipping. Page up scrolls back to earlier dialogue. Page down rolls forward to later dialogue. H hides the user interface. S takes a screenshot. Oh, heck yeah. Shift plus A opens the accessibility menu. And F opens the game in full screen. Alright. We're gonna start, we're gonna play. welcome to Lion's Pride. You've come here to apply as one of our servers. Is that correct? Yes, that is correct. All right, may I ask you what your name is?
Halo.
Enter. Is Halo the correct spelling?
Yes. My name is Halo.
Now, what pronouns do you... Certified best game ever already. Certified best game ever. I believe that, another, like, Otome-type game did this. If you don't know what... Crap, what was it called? Well, now I have to look it up, otherwise I'll be annoyed. Give me a minute. Otome. I feel like it was Choices. It's not Choices. It's kind of like Obey Me. Never played Obey Me. Oh, let's see. Where is it? It's not Mystic Messenger. It was LGBT, that one I can tell you. Where is it? Not Darling Pet, but I do love Darling Pet. I need to start recording that one. I need to record that one badly. Okay. It's somewhere. Give me a minute. What was it called? It wasn't Choices. It was something like it. What was it? I'm finding it. I promise I can find it. I'ma find it. I am. Set on finding it now. It has to be somewhere. Maybe it's on my wish list. Let me check. Library? Wish list. Yes, wish list. Okay. No. Not that one either. Let's see. Mechogram. Let's see. Where is it? Narutome chat? Psychonostalka, I still need to download that on my phone. I need to get it on computer. That's what I need to do. Shizuka Talk, I still have not downloaded that one. I have so many things on my wish list, bro. VTubers appearing, whatever. Okay, where is it? It's somewhere. I know it's somewhere. Come on. Please. For the love of God. Let's make a game. No, not that one. No. Oh, come on. It had a rainbow heart on it. For like the main, like the app picture profile thingy. People might understand what I'm talking about if they've played it. Basically, you could choose what gender you were interested in. I took many screenshots, and I know I posted it to Instagram at one point. When in doubt, just go to your Instagram, honestly. But, like, I was, like, having an absolute, like, I know one of them was like someone got almost isekai'd into a fantasy thing. Like you're playing it and everything, and you basically get like accidentally hit by something, like a bus, basically an isekai'd into a fantasy thing. Not anything that you've watched, it's just random. And then you're with this like, you see this elf dude and this magical girl looking person. Please tell me at least one of you know what I'm talking about, please, I'm begging you. I want at least one of you to understand what I'm talking about. Without having to actually find it. I have it. It's somewhere. Where is it? I've got it. Hold on. Give me a minute. scroll. Keep scrolling. It can't be this far down, can it? I got screenshots of. Yeah. What? This is past. No, I know I've posted about it. I know for a fact I have. I know for a fact I posted about it. Where is it? Please. The one moment I rely on you and you fail me. I still love that picture of the hot chocolate. Delicious. I want hot chocolate now with the nice, whipped cream. Now. Whipped cream. Bro. There's no way I deleted it. I know for a fact I didn't delete it. Just found my post that I put, imagine eating barbecue chips. This post was made by the Cheese Bits gang. Imagine eating Cheese Bits. This post was made by the barbecue chip gang. It's here. It's existing. I know it is. I posted it. I know I did. Because I was going absolutely wild. I hope at least one of you know what I'm talking about. Please know what I'm talking about. Maybe it is farther down, is it? This music is a bop, though. Certified bop. Aha! I found it! I found it! I can't remember what the game was called. I do not have the name of the game. But it was so nice. Let's see. One of the quotes is, Isul, no, I know I can do better. It had to do with heterochromia, blue and red eyes. I think it was like a knight. But yeah, it said, do you prefer men or women? So yeah. God, I don't have the name of it on there. That sucks. Anyways, I kind of found it. Okay, anyways, they, them. To make sure I got it right, you prefer to be addressed as they, them, correct? Yes. Alright. Anyway, we have reviewed your application, and your qualifications, congratulations, you got the job. You'll be starting your first shift soon, and also, the boss often hangs around here, so don't be too surprised if you see him around. I see. That's a little nerve-wracking, isn't it? He approached you for this job, right? I'm sure he vouches for you. You don't need to be nervous. He's a good man at heart. I'm sure you know that. Bye-bye. Alright. I like it's just lion's pride. That's pretty. This entire... I wish I could draw rooms, but I can't relate. It's my first day. So far, everything is going smoothly. Ah, ye... It has no shading. It's okay, it's still gorgeous either way. I'll forgive it. I'll forgive the lack of shading, my man. Still better than I can do. Oh my god, they can draw hands. Hands, my beloved. Alright. Wait, isn't that boss? I still have to thank him for letting me have this job. He seems to be talking to some people. Maybe his friends? Better stay away to avoid bothering him. Oh? Halo, over here! Huh? He's waving at me. Why is he shouting? I saved a seat for you. Come over. You can't reject your boss, right? He's calling me. Wait, I would like to know about the voice. Who would be speaking? Do tell. He's calling me. I should go to them. As embarrassing as it is. Coming! I run over to the table where the boss and four other men are. I can't help but feel nervous when I take an empty seat, taking a glance at one of them. The person who got my attention first is the man who's devilishly attractive. Oh, my bad. My shoulder's itchy. Give me a minute. Yeah. The famous detective that everyone keeps talking about. The man with the curious hair color. What does that mean? curious hair color. Oh, they mean shoe. Okay. I was very confused for a minute. The man with glasses and fancy earrings, or the man whose appearance doesn't match his smile? The man with the glasses. There we go. I could never not earrings, unless they're clip-ons. And even then, I'm afraid they'd probably fall off. A gentle-looking man with dyed hair and glasses. Who's to say it's dyed? He looks so out of place here. And those piercings and earrings. The designs are so detailed and intricate. The earrings are quite unique as well. So, why did you call me over here, boss? Nothing, just felt like it. Now, let's get you some drink. Double A. Here comes that boy. Would you mind introducing them to us, Luca? It'd only be polite to get us acquainted first. Oh, yeah, sorry, my bad. So, guys, we have to be careful around this new wild species named Halo. They're the silliest, bestest, fun incarnate I've met so far. I am the new species called Wolf Person. A very rare one. Be gentle with them, because they can get quite aggressive if you push them too far. if you corner them, they'll kill you. You're talking about this person right here, right? I don't think that's really a nice way to introduce someone. What is this, interdimensional geography? Geographic. No, my bad. I'm stupid. Interdimensional geographic. Oh, wait, look at Shoe looking snazzy. Wait, I like his little chain thingy and the little two shikigami, whatever the heck they're called, that are hanging from it. It reminds me. It reminds me of my banana man. Fair enough. No, because the chain thing reminds me of my cargo shorts. They have a belt loop, and they have an ungodly amount of keychains. They have 13 and counting. I will be having 14 soon. Well, actually, so of those 13, 3 of them are on the other side, on the other belt loop on my other, like on my left side, because that has 2 pride hearts, one of which I'm giving to my friend because I accidentally got the asexual one and not the non-binary one. They had the same colors in my defense, and the bisexual heart from that I got from WasabiCon, and also the Electro Inazuma Vision that I got from WasabiCon, so. But it works, right? I feel like I know them more now. See, Shu gets me. Feeling a little more awkward than earlier, I try to look elsewhere and notice someone raising their hand to order. I'll get back to work. I see another table ordering. It was lovely meeting you all, though. Please excuse me. I jolt up before immediately running off to get that order done. I must have made an embarrassment out of myself with that interaction. Hello, Fleet. How are you doing today? Love you. I love you so much. Haha, you're now trapped under the table. Haha, he cannot move. And there they go. Wow, I didn't know they could run that fast. Haha. Pog! I cringe eternally when I say that. The word fits Luca, but it does not fit me. They seem very nice. I wonder if I can see them again in the future. It's still... Da boy is still sending me. It's... Okay! I thought we'd only be seeing Luxium. Nah, we've seen everyone. Halo, come over here. I got something for you. I still like his... As you can see, I have heterophobia. I mean, heterochromia. What is it? It's some notes that the boss man and his friends left for you. I didn't bother to read any of it, though. But look at you, such a charmer, already getting notes from customers on your first day. Thanks, I'll take a look at them. Just pick the one you like. Let's see, which one should I choose? Oh god darn it. Would you like a drink? It's on me, of course. Want to find the solution for the case called You and Me. had a fun first day. If you're ever in the dark, you can come to me. I got you. Would you like a drink or a drink over a book or two? Know who that one is. Halo, want to catch up with me after work? I'm not sure. If I clicked I'm not sure, would that give me a random answer? Out of curiosity, I must find out.
with a look, Halo. If you're unsure which one's your type, just ask me. I know all about them. Which one am I most curious about? Okay, so. Can you please tell me more about the writer of this note? He's an enigma. He radiates such a gentle aura, but I can sense that there's darkness within. Ooh. Anyways, he seems like a nice guy. The peacemaker of the group, I would say, if I had to assign a role. That's pretty much all I know about them. Do you need anything else, or are you ready to pick now? Which one should I choose? Yoink! I'll get going now, though. Got something to do later. Have fun, babe! See you tomorrow, Uki. Thank you. Uki waves as he excuses himself from work for today. I look down to the note I chose, a smile curling on my lips. I wonder if the person behind the note is like what Uki described to me. Only one way to find out, Halo. I walk into the cabaret the next day, as ordered by my boss as a means of relaxing. I read cabaret and my mind automatically goes to the Masa song? Grand Cabaret? I think that's what it's called, yeah. The Grand Cabaret. I'm 110% sure that's what it's called. Give me a minute, I have to check now. Masa, my beloved. Yep, Grand Cabaret, that's what it's called. So, whenever I read that word, I'm just like, Masa. It's Masa, there is nothing else, it's only Masa. Anyways. So this is what a gathering's like. Boss told me about it, but I never thought it'd be so big. I wonder if I'll meet the person who wrote the note I chose. We'll see. Oh, he looks familiar. Should I talk to him? Who should I talk to? The man who's devilishly attractive? It's just mysterious. Wait, how do we get his name but not the rest? I am confusion. We didn't get his name, like, but we heard Shu's name. It doesn't say Shudo. Okay, so I guess it was technically stated famous detective, so actually it makes sense. The man with glasses and fancy earrings, Luka Kanoshiro. There we go. I remember the apparel designs of one of my boss's friends. They stand out among the crowd, pulling me forward to approach him, looking at me with a gentle smile. Hello, glasses posh guy. These people are coming up with some very, like, creative names. Hello there, you're the one Luke introduced us to, right? Ah, yes, that was me. I remember he said something along the lines of, we have to be careful around this new wild species named Halo. They're the silliest and bestest fun incarnate I've met so far, a very rare one. Be gentle with them, because they can get quite aggressive if you push them too far. I dare you to do so. Yeah. Oh, did you not like that? Sorry, I'm sure Luca didn't mean to make you feel uncomfortable. Nor did I. Ah, it's perfectly fine, don't worry about it. Speaking of which, I never introduced myself, did I? Whoops. I'm Mike Eveland, a friend of Luca's. It's nice to meet you, Halo. Oh no, the pleasure's all mine, Mr. Eveland. Mr. Eveland? It's like when he says, why do you have to call me Ike Eveland? Is it so hard to be on a first name basis? Mr. Eveland, it's very kind of you to be so polite, but there's no need to be formal with me. After all, I'm just a regular novelist. It's okay to just call me Ike. I'll try to remember that. Thank you. Philippe, what are you doing? Are you just existing? Are you having fun? Are you going to proceed to use he's using my foot as a pillow. This would not be the first time he has done that. Alright, hold on. I need to fix the thingies. Wait, what am I doing? Okay. Why am I tilted up some? Give me a moment. Reset the position. There we go. No, I'm not tilted up as much. Okay. I'll try to remember that. Thank you. Before we can speak anymore, I hear someone calling for me to their table, so I had to say a quick goodbye to Ike before answering the ones calling me. I still have some time left. Who should I talk to? The man who's devilishly attractive, Mr. Rias, the man with the curious hair color, Ike Eveland, Luka Kanoshiro. If we went to talk to Ike again, would he just be like, oh hey, nice to talk to you again? Or I'm being biased. As I move to the sides of the room, while it's been nice to mingle with everyone, I sometimes like being out of the spotlight for a bit. Near my spot is Ike, who looks to be doing the same as me. So, Halo, is the party to your liking? It's definitely fun, but a little too loud for me. What about you, Mr. Eveland? The crowd's a bit overwhelming, but I'm enjoying myself nonetheless. Also, I told you to just call me Ike. I don't want you to feel pressure just because I know Luca. You can speak as casually with me as you'd like. Sorry, I'm just not used to it. It's alright, I'm sorry if I seem pushy about it. You just seem so nervous around me that I wanted to ease the tension a little. Did I overstep? No, I appreciate the gesture a lot. Maybe with a bit more time it'll come more naturally to me. Am I that scary? I apologize, I'm not that great at talking with someone new. But if you feel too pressured, just let me know, alright? I want to get to know you better without making you feel uncomfortable. Got it, Mr. E. I mean Ike. I'll let you know. From the distance, I can hear a hey, Eichel from the crowd, getting a reaction from Ike. That's Luca, 110%. Oh, excuse me. I think someone's calling me. Let's talk again eventually, okay? Sounds good to me. With a nod and wave, Ike walks off back into the crowd, leaving me with my thoughts at the side. I think I have just enough time for one more conversation. Who should I talk to? Ike Eveland. Okay, we'll go see Shu. Remembering the familiar colored hair that I previously saw, I thought it would be a good idea to approach him first. Weird hair, dude. Me too. You must be the new recruit, Halo, right? I'm Shu Yamino, the manager of Lion's Pride. Oh crap, what up? I've heard a lot about you, especially from Luke Boss. It's nice to meet you, and I hope you have a nice time working here. You're the manager? I take a step back, eyes widening in shock. Should I call you Mr. Yamino then? I hope I wasn't rude. Don't worry. Just call me Shu. You don't need to be so tense when you're around me, and besides, we're both employees here. Shu keeps a calm demeanor and with a smile, and I can't help but relax too. He seems so kind too. I have a good feeling that he's very well liked by our colleagues. Eventually, the manager leaves to deal with some work. It will be dinner soon. I wonder what is for dinner. As I lay on my bed, I suddenly hear my phone ring. Raising my eyebrow, I pick up my phone to check who it is. It's Boss. Hello, Boss? Hey, Halo. Sorry for calling you at such a late time, but I never properly introduced the guy's names to you yesterday, didn't I? No, you didn't. Let me fix that then. I'll list them all other than myself so that you at least know who they are. They sometimes come to the cabaret to look for me, so it's convenient if you do. The first one is Ike Eveland, the one with all the gold accessories and whatnot. I'm sure you two will get along. He seems like a good guy who would be nice to talk to. Then, you most likely will get to know Shu, one of the managers here at the cabaret. He's the one with the purple suit. Pretty pog, if I say so myself. Then I hope to learn more about him in the future. After that is Vox, the one with the black hair. He's very polite, so don't worry about approaching him for anything. If that's what you say, boss, I'll make sure to remember that. And finally, other than me, you'll meet your mean and evil boss, you have Mista. Word is that he's a famous detective, which is definitely true. Oh yes, I've definitely heard about him. Thank you for introducing all of them to me. No problem. Now have a good sleep, yeah? Nighty night now. Paw! And with that, the phone call ends. I can't help but smile before placing my phone down and letting myself fall asleep, happy with the encounters I made today. Not because the pog, but then cutting off before he finishes reminds me of me and my sister whenever we're just like, she'll call me at random times, just say one some random sound and then dip. Like, she tried to say something with a Y in the beginning, I can't remember what it was supposed to be, but hung up before she could finish it. Or, like, she'll call me at random times and quote Corey Kenshin going, "You get a shout out, dude!" And then just end the call right there. It's so funny. And I do the same thing, so. It's such a good looking building, and how are you people drawing this well? This is cheating. Finally, my shift's over. Feels like I've been in here forever with all this constant roaring and music. I can go back home and get some much needed rest. Wait, I hear people in the distance. I'll talk to you later. See you tomorrow, Luca. Aw, bye, Ikey Wikey! The two are waving to each other as Boss turns away. It sounds like their conversation just ended. The other person heads towards the door with efficient steps, coming closer to me. Wait, it's... Ah, I didn't even see you there. I'm so sorry about that, Halo. Mr. Evelyn stops when he sees me. The surprised look on his face turns into his usual gentle expression, which makes me almost automatically smile in return. It's alright, Mr. Evelyn. I mean, Ike. No need to trouble yourself over, Halo. You'll get used to it in no time. Yeah. Anyways, you're headed out, right? Then please, let me walk you home. It's getting dark out, and I'd feel terrible if I let you go all alone by yourself.
Y'all, ow, cat, you hurt my... owie.
Oh no, it disappeared. I said, see ya. Wouldn't wanna be ya. Anyways, sorry, I was talking to my nanny. She came in to ask me what I wanted to eat. We had the option of chicken noodle soup or Little Smokies, so I chose Little Smokies, and then tomorrow I will be having chicken noodle soup. So that's delicious. Anyways, continuing on, it's getting dark out, and I'd feel terrible if I let you go by yourself.
Thank you.
I'll be alright by myself. I'd love to. Yes, I'd love to. Then it's settled. Which direction should we be heading to get to your place? Oh, it's in Rainpuff Hotel. Oh, Pomo! Should be a short walk north. Ah, so over there. If you're alright with it, may I suggest taking a little detour? I assure you, it will be worth a walk. I don't mind. I would prefer heading straight home. I don't mind. Is there good sights to see on the detour? Do tell. I would love to know. Is there a amusement park? I would like to go to the amusement park. Wonderful. Shall I move along? I don't see why not. Besides, that just means I can get to know him a little more. I let Mr. Evelyn lead the way as he guides me through the streets on the little detour he wants us to take. Oh, it is pretty. So the place Ike wanted to take me was the park. It's quite deserted at this time of night. Cat! I'm getting more chalky milk. Kitty. But since it's just me and Ike, I think this type of scenery has its own charm. We've been talking for a while, and so far things seem to be going well. Can we talk about Vocaloid? Sir, let me just introduce you to how vocal synths work. I can teach you how to use Utau and Vocaloid and Synth V and Chevio. I could give you the activation code to my EA Type C English, because it has two more uses left. I can teach you how to make an Utau voice bank, Your Honor. Man, Boss can be pretty loud, huh? Yeah, he can be quite loud at times, but that's just Luca. I heard his voice from across the room when I was getting ready to leave, though it's actually very endearing. It's super annoying. No, it's endearing. I'm glad you agree, Halo. imagine his reaction if you said otherwise. That would have been instant death. I'm convinced that's instant death. You can't just insult Luca, instant death. You will die. Alright. Speaking of Luca, I never got to ask, how are you enjoying your job so far? I like it. Pays well, I get to experience a party atmosphere, and best of all, I got to meet you, Ike. Oh? His face is turning red. Ha, the movie. That's so cute. I've never even seen the movie. Why did I just say that? Oh, it doesn't show his red face. How dare you? Well, you're quite the smooth talker, and you call me by my first name, Halo. I'm so proud of you. He's proud of me, boys. Me? Smooth talker? I don't even know how to process all of that. I can feel my face heating up from hearing it. Oh, you mentioned that you're a novelist, right? What kind of books have you written? Well, I'm not one to write within a specific genre, but I do enjoy a good story with a sweet or sad ending. Aw, I've always liked stories with sweet endings. Are you working on anything at the moment? Sir, I can only do one-shots, unfortunately. Well, no, actually, I take that back. I used to be able to read longer fanfic stories that had chapters upon chapters, but then I just got addicted to one-shots because my attention span is crap, and the only fanfiction I have read that is A, has a lot of chapters, B, is not an ex-reader, is Unprecedented Collisions. Yes, I am giving that a shout-out. Shut up. It's so good, and I can't wait for chapter 42. I reread that thing daily. You don't understand. Anyways, are you working on anything at the moment? Actually, there is something in the works. Can you tell me more about it? I'm not sure if you really want to hear me go on a tangent about it, but I'm interested, Ike, please? Alright, if you don't mind it then. I've been working on this novel that focuses on this cheesy romance plot where... Whoa, he sounds so passionate when talking about this. The way he's telling the story in such extreme detail shows he's really dedicated. Oh my god, look at the eyes! The big hap. Wait, I swear to god, I saw something about mentioned of the alter egos too. Do we get to see Eki and slash or Ivy? That would be... Please. Please let me see Ivy, my queen, my king, my queen, Ivy, my god, my goddess. Yes. Ivy, my beloved. Alright. It's hard to look away from him, and I can't help but listen to everything with a grin. Sorry, it's obvious with how I'm writing the novel that I have quite the view on romance. It's super cheesy, but I love exploring it this way. Capturing the idea of love in the purest sense by connecting two souls, it sounds like the ideal love life for me. The way he speaks so happily, it's so infectious. I can feel the soreness of my cheeks from smiling. Oh, that was a cloak. Oof! It's because he's wearing heels, that's why. He's wearing heels, that's why. I can see the stick. This poor dude. This poor dude. No! Rest in peace. At least the bush was there to cushion his fall, I suppose. I do not know. I'm gonna save this in case it just decides to give me air. In case it decides to, like... crash. Anyways, rip dude. Oof. Ike! Laugh at him, help him up. Oh, I want to laugh at him so badly. I want to laugh at him so badly. You don't know how badly I want to laugh at him.
Yay! No, food is next.
Alright, thank you.
So if you need the tray or whatever.
What?
If you need the tray or whatever, I'll let you know. It's in the kitchen.
Uh-huh.
Get it. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
No,
yeah. What happens if I laugh at him? What happens if I laugh at him? I need to know. If I laugh at him, will he take it lightheartedly? That's what matters here. That's why I saved. Because I would laugh at anyone. Not as in, ha ha, you're stupid. No, it's a ha, you fell. Actually, it would kind of be a ha, you're stupid. But like in a lighthearted way. Is this also... a lighthearted way. That's what I need to know. Please. I want to laugh at him Ike looks up at me with a sharp glare as I laugh at him. I can't help it. He looks so silly when he tripped over. Hey, it was the big funny. Wait, was I saying things? He's not actually glaring. So sorry about that. It's getting late now, so let's get going. The walk back is pretty quiet, all things considered. Where'd the music go? Come back. We arrived at my apartment and waved our goodbyes, going our separate ways. Perhaps I shouldn't have left, but it's too late to go back now. You wanna bet? Ike! Alright, we'll help him up this time. But it was funny. We laugh. It's the funny and it's the laugh. It's funny. To laugh is funny. Why would you...
I didn't mean to hurt his feelings, but it was funny. It was the big funny. Please, I beg you.
Reaching my hand towards him, he accepts it and stands up prior to dusting himself off a little abashedly before facing me again. Thank you, Halo. Are you alright? Oh, I'm perfectly fine. Just a small slip. Nothing too bad. I'm more embarrassed than anything. That aside, it seems to be getting darker. Let's get moving. The two of us move to the direction of my apartment. The atmosphere is peaceful. But laughing is funnier. Laughing option is better because it's lighthearted laughing. It's funny. People falling is funny. Especially children. Little kids falling on their face. That's the funniest thing in the world.
Hey!
I will hurt you! You're the one who got under there. Why would you try and bite my leg like that? Rude. Go. Continue walking. Yes. But move on. Why are you in a mood? Why are you always in a mood of running around acting like you're brand new? Okay. Rude. Asshole. Anyways. My point made. Eki clearly has never met a cat before. Anyways. We're able to have more smaller... Don't you dare. But I must pet you. Alright. I had to pet the kitty cat, unfortunately. Oof. Alright. Turn. Alright. We're able to have more small chatter while walking, while still going on a few tangents every now and then, and being sure to watch where we're stepping along the way. But the laughing one was better! It seems we made it. I had a lot of fun. Thank you for indulging me a little bit. I should be thanking you for walking me home. I enjoyed being able to talk to a lot with you as well. Maybe we can do more of that another time. Until then, have a pleasant night. The two of us wave to one another as Ike leaves. With joy in my heart, I'm able to be at ease while heading up to my apartment, locking it since I'm alone and fall asleep. It's only that much. Darn. Wait, then how did someone find the David Goon? Wait, I'm confused. The demo was still all Bob. Who can wait, come back. Wait, so I'm gonna reload this one. I wanna see the rest of Laugh at Him. I slowly drift off to sleep, thinking about what I can do to make it up to him. Oh, okay. Alright, then we'll go to the other routes too. Let's go other routes. I love that outfit, though. Whose outfit is that? That's what we need in life. Max 15 characters. Enter. I hit shift on accident. Yes. My name Halo. My name is Halo. They, them. Yes. Okay, continue. Yes. Keep going. We already know this. Speed run. Alright. Gonna go to Mesta. Ah, the famous detective Mr. Vias? He looks so much younger in real life. His glasses! He's looking this way. I wonder if he's just like what the newspapers say. Ayo, it rhymed. What the? What did the newspaper say? So why'd you call me over, boss? That thing just felt like it. Now, let's get you some drink. Da boy. Would you mind introducing them to us, Luca? It would only be polite to get us acquainted first. We've already seen all this. Continue on, please, and thank you. Keep going. Interdimensional Geographic. National Geographic? No. Interdimensional Geographic. Yes, go wait, other tables. Okay, continue on. That person kept looking at me. Luca, do you know more about him? I'm intrigued. Uki's back, boys. In the full game, will we see more of Uki? That would be 11 out of 10. The boss man. Okay, let's see. Which one should I choose? We absolutely already know who this is. I can go now. Got something to do later. Oh, what do you have to do later? What does he have to do later, though? I want to know what the... Like, is it only just what the choices were, or was there more to the note and they just didn't write it? Nah, that'd have been amazing. They tried to, like, copy Mista's horrid handwriting. That crap is worse than mine, bro. That I did not know that was possible. Excuse you. I hope you do not think you are getting under the thing. You're gonna have to copy it on me. Sir, are you on crack today? You better not start trying to attack my leg again. I swear to God, you are not Ladybug. Oh, he looks familiar. Should I talk to him? Who should I talk to? I wonder. Mista. While looking in the crowd, I spot a familiar brunette peeking out. When he turns to face me, he gives me a grin before coming over. Oh, so he approached us this time. Okay. Hey, you new around here? Yes, why are you asking? Food?
It's ready.
Yay! Philippe. I shall return momentarily. Give me a moment. Nah, because 3D models be wild in the moment you get out of the camera view. Or the moment you actually walk away from the camera. Oh, okay, hold on. Reset the position. Alright, there we go. We're good now. I have my foods. Yes, why are you asking? And then I could... I thought so. I've never seen... No! Not... So I found where the David Kuhn references. I thought so. I've never seen you before. What is he talking about? Sorry, I got it from your boss. You should blame him. He keeps repeating this meme around us, and it's rubbed off on me. Anyways, I'm Mr. Vias, a detective. Nice to meet you. Okay? Nice to meet you too, Mr. Vias. Mysterious kind of sounds like mysterious. Mysterious kind of sounds like mysterious. Mysterious is also technically just Rius. Coincidence? I think not. I'm Halo. Mysterious. Mysterious. When you share one half a brain cell with a VTuber. We were sharing a singular brain cell, unfortunately. I haven't had a little smokers in a hot minute, so this is nice. Anyways. Moving on. Alright. Okay. Mysterious. Mysterious, mysterious. It's like you're saying my name either way. Just go Sirius. Or just do Mr. in literally any other languages. Ha ha! Senorius. Dia-san, there we go. Oh, yeah. Right? It's funny. But you can call me whatever you want. Even yours. Just kidding. So how have you been? Any cases that need solving?
Cat. Stop that.
Cat. No, not really. Are you having fun, though? I'm glad you asked. I am having fun. I hope you are, too. That's good to know. Before I speak another word, I hear a phone ring from someone nearby. Judging by Mr.'s reaction, it's most likely his. Ah, someone's calling for me. Sorry for cutting our chat short. Talk to you later, alright? I have a feeling we'll meet again soon. It's alright. Take care, mister. Mr. nods before taking his phone to answer the call and waves, walking off as he whispers a few words that I can't hear to whoever's calling. With a look at his face, it looks like he's in work mode. Oof! I still have some time left. Who should I talk to? Consume. I'll go to Vox. I remember the Tomcat. Why?
Pet, pet, pet. Pet the cat, pet the cat. He needs pets. He needs pets daily.
He deserves pets daily. Anyways. I remember the tall man from the group. He didn't talk much, but he has this charismatic aura that makes me want to approach him. Here comes that boy! Oh, showing up! Fortunately, I can see him in the crowd, at the counter with a drink in his hand, because he's so tall, bro. Anyways. Devil man! Wait, no, it's demon devil car. It was a meme. Anyways, hey, fancy seeing you here. Halo, was it? Yeah, that's me. And you are? Ah, oh, rude of me. Terribly sorry. My name is Vox Akuma. I'm a friend and a business partner of Luca's. Hello, Trakel. You might remember me from that time he called you over at the cabaret. So that's where I've seen him before. Oh, it's nice to officially meet you, Mr. Akuma. No need for formalities, please. Call me Vox. Of course, Vox. So it's easy with the Vox, but not with Ike. I'm sensing favoritism. I shall consume more little smokies. Yum. Give me a moment. Give me a moment with me and my love. Delicious. The two of us share a few jokes together before I bid him goodbye due to being called by a co-worker who wants to welcome me to the crew. I think I have just enough time for one more conversation. Who should I talk to? Hold on. I'm going to go get a Coke. So yeah, I will go get a Coke, and then I'll be back. I'll be trading out my chalky milk. I forgot to get that when I was out there first. Oops! Thank you. gonna go back to shoot. Wait, no, I should have gone to Eichel. Should have gone to the Eichel the Eagle. Anyways. Oh, my fingers. I hope we got the crack opening of a can. I didn't focus on that, my bad. I apologize. Okay. Remember the familiar colored hair that I previously saw? I thought it would be a good idea to approach him first. Weird hair, dude. Yes. You must be the new recruit, Halo, right? I'm Shuyamino, the manager of Lion's Pride. We've already saw all this. I should have chosen him second. Oof. Okay, that kind of looks like a nice bedroom, not gonna lie. That bed looks comfy. Mm-hmm. Alright, hello, boss. Okay, we've already seen all this. Continue. Middle of the afternoon, boss and Shoe are out for today, and people are only just getting off work. Oh, wait, oh, so this is different from Ike's. Whoa! The cabaret is so slow at this time of day that I'm practically dying for something to do. I start daydreaming about the chores I still have to do at home until I hear someone at the door. Oh, is there finally another customer?
Willie, why are you like this to me?
Wait, that's Mr. I jolt up, straightening my back. I can't relate. I do not have a straight back. I hunch over. Or bend over. Whatever. And give a friendly smile. It hurts when I do this, since I have been slouching while looking through my phone when there was nothing to do. Yeah, accurate. I have to look like I'm working after all. Welcome to- Oh, hello, mister. You seem busy today, huh? He says that in such a sarcastic tone. Funny though, so I can't help but chuckle a little bit. Mr. Lin looks like he triumphed with that little comment. Not really, there aren't many customers today. After all, did you see anything in particular? No, did you need anything in particular? Nope. Also, I'm sorry for leaving you like that yesterday. Oh, don't worry about it, you probably had something important to attend to. You could have stayed for a bit longer, but it's fine, I guess. No. Yeah. He scratches his head and gives a small chuckle. Whatever it was, Mista isn't mentioning it now. Or so I thought. He looks at me once again, eyes hinting that he had something on his mind. But anyways, want to help me out with this case? Not really much of a detective. I don't have any experience in this area. And can you even share details with the case with outsiders? Come on, I'm sure you could help a little bit. You seem like you know a thing or two. Yeah, I know a thing or two. Because I've played Gondo and Rampa. That's how I know a thing or two. We know a thing or two because we've seen a thing or two. Haha! I'm a genius. There you go. He takes out my magnifying glass from his pocket and looks at me with it, his one eye visibly huge through the lens. Nah, because that's what me and Aoife do. Me and my little sister, she wears glasses, so she'll take off the glasses and then just put them up to her eyes. So she's like holding them with her eyes and it makes her eyes gigantic, and it's the funniest thing, especially if you put them on backwards. So where the parts rest on your ears, they're facing, like, you and not her, and she's holding it. It looks so funny, dude. Mr. winks with his gigantic eye in a way that was perhaps intended to be flirtatious. How cute. A Is that a compliment? Thanks, I'll try my best. Mr. scrunches his face for a bit, as if trying to think of what to do. As he does, I unconsciously go back to scrolling through my phone. After a few seconds, he lets out a ha! I get startled and jump, almost dropping my phone before looking back at the man in front of me, a gleam in his eyes as if he struck gold. How about we go for a walk? You seem like you need some cheering up. Or at least something more interesting to do than slacking off. Does your shift end soon? I look at the time on my phone. Almost done. Yeah, in about 20 minutes. Then I'll wait here for you until it's over. You don't have to do that. I mean, you don't have to, and are you sure you don't want anything? An empty stomach is not good for ideas. Mr. makes his way to an empty seat and takes a quick look at the menu. Then, one mango boba tea, please. And just like you said, he waits for me and my shift to end, but not without trying to keep a conversation going with me. He enjoys his mango boba tea whilst I try to make sure that the very few people in the cabaret are attended to. Philippe, why are you like this? If you want anything else, just tell me. Catering to all our guests is my job, after all. Of course, but the actual guest should be your first priority. I'm just sitting here to walk with you after your shift ends. Thanks, mister. You really don't have to, but I appreciate it. No, I want to get somewhere with you. How can I do that without having you with me? So, waiting here is the most rational option. Oh my god, he's being rational. Okay. The last few minutes of my working shift ends just like that. After I change out of my working uniform, we immediately leave the cabaret and continue on our way. Haha, cabaret way. Ha 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 ha. Must consume food in order to stay alive. Wherever our destination may be, as long as it's with Mister, I'm sure it's gonna be interesting either way. Can't confirm. Why did you become a detective? Does it have something to do with your family? A detective, huh? Why'd you decide to become one? They both sound like the same god darn question, bro. We'll just do this one to be safe. That's a secret. Secrets are like mysteries, which is nice since I'm a detective. So, being a mystery is a good image, don't you think? And speaking of mysteries, what about you? Was your dream anything grand or something entirely different than the job you have now? Not that I mind or anything. That was a smooth topic change. I guess he doesn't want to talk about it. Oh well. Actually, I really like my current job in the cabaret. Being able to have small conversations with guests is pretty nice, as it helps me improve my skills of talking to strangers. But I also like the faces they make when their food or drink arrives. They all look so satisfied or amazed. I'm still recovering from my Coke addiction. My diet Coke addiction, that is. Ha! But I think I can still improve on picking up cues, you know? Like what that guest in front of me actually wants, or whether that person over there is alright or in need of help. I'm still having a hard time in that department. Any suggestions on how to improve? I do have an idea. He holds up one of his fingers, his eyes starting to glitter with a mischievous glint. Oh! No. Since you've already agreed on helping me with my case, why don't you help out every time I need assistance? Then, you get to interact with other people and learn to pick up cues much easier, yeah? As cunning as a fox, Mr. brings up the topic of me helping him on his case again. You really want me to help you with your case that badly, huh? I guess I won't be able to weasel myself out of every situation in the future. Alright, sure, I'll help you. Mr. claps his hands together and seems satisfied with my answer. Why does my nose keep getting stuffed? Whatever. As we continue along the footpath, I begin to notice a fun fair in the distance. Ooh. Consider me interested. I read the part. I haven't really been to one in a long time, and right now, it seems like a good opportunity. Hey, wanna go check that out? Well, I'm not usually a fan of fairs because they tend to be crowded. But it seems calm for now. I guess it wouldn't hurt to visit. That's the spirit. We can try everything out. Yeah, sure we can. Not sure if I'm good at anything there, though, so no promise. With that decided, our next destination is the fun fair. Next destination, what about your final destination? We about to die. Anyways, it also seems like a good opportunity to have fun with another person. Hopefully, Mystic can have fun at the fair with me. Let's think positive for now, or else I might jinx it. You've already jinxed it. Knock on wood. The last thing I need to do is make a bad impression to close friends of my boss. Who knows what could happen to me if this doesn't go well. I immediately try clearing my head of intrusive thoughts and replace them with happier ones to match the occasion. Can knock down? That's it, just can. Oh, not can I knock it down, it's just can, like can and then knock down. Okay. Why not knock down can? Pringles! We have Pringles, we have the banana. Oh wait, no, it's the mistakes. We can find the mistakes here. I still can't figure out if that orange is a mouth. We have, like, little monkeys, I think. I don't know. Bloom Pop. Oh, darts. Walking into the fair, we sigh with relief once we see that it's not too crowded. It's so good. The music is so good. It almost reminds me of the clown music that Mr. put on at one point. Walking into the fair, we sigh with... Oh, wait, no, I already read that. Whatever. Mr. seems to be having fun as well. Thank the heavens, if I was the only one having fun, I wouldn't be able to relax as much. Wow, there's so many stalls. I wonder what else they might have. Do you want to get some food? Sure. I'll take some cotton candy. Mango boba for me. He really likes that drink. Why else would he order repeatedly? We grab an order and resume our merry walk through the fair again. Fair food is good, though, okay? Have you ever had, like, funnel cake? Or better yet, they're like deep-fried Oreos? Have you ever had deep-fried Oreos? Those are good. Deep-fried Oreos are delicious. Like, delicious. And a popcorn. Although, when I was at the carnival, the last time I had their Coke, it literally tasted like cigarette smoke. That was the sweet tea. The sweet tea was the literal definition of tasting cigarette smoke. It was wild. I hated it. And I usually love sweet tea, too. That's the worst part about it. Oof. Now then, let's see. One stall with many plushies catches my eye as we walk by. Over there, there's a shooting game. I feel like a child again getting excited over stuff like this. Hello. Stand owner. Come try your luck. Win amazing prizes. Shoot 3 cans and the prize is all yours. I can do it. I can do it. I know I can. Hey, you two, want to try it out for yourselves? Oh, can we try it? The childlike excitement I am feeling must have been pretty visible. Mr. seems interested in trying the shooting game with me. Well, it seems like a lot of fun. But guess who's trashy in the shooting department? Exactly, me. Then I guess I won't embarrass myself in front of him. But which one of us should go first? Since we're both trash, I'm sure me going first isn't a problem. I'm probably even better than you. Come on, Mister, I believe in you and your skills, so no need to trash talk yourself there, man. We'll go this way. With a confident smile, he immediately pays the man and takes the gun with ease. Alright, aim and... In a cool fashion, he manages to shoot all the targets and make the cans fall. Not one of his shots misses its target, making it more impressive in my eyes. That was amazing. He actually is skilled at shooting guns. Dang, Mister, you actually are, in terms of my boss, pretty pog at this. You think? I'm not really sure, but thanks. Congratulations, you won the top prize. The fox. Yes, it's a fox. I want it. Wait, I didn't. He grabs an orange plushie and hands it to Mister. Is it a fox or a panda? Is it gay or European? I'm not entirely sure, but whatever it is, it's really fluffy and soft to the touch. It's also really adorable to look at, just like Mister, who is holding it in his arms. Seeing Mister like this kind of makes my heart flutter for some reason. I hope your partner can enjoy this nice present. Ayo? Partner? No way, sir. think you read the situation wrong. We're just friends, isn't that right, mister? Oof. Oh, I'm sorry, sir. We're actually not dating. Would be a nice idea, though. Right, mister? So, which is the better situation here? Mister doesn't seem to react to my voice, so I take him by the hand and quickly leave the shooting game stall. That was really surprising. Why did he think I was his partner? And why am I actually not bothered by the idea? Did our interaction look that way or something? Ugh, my face feels warm thinking about that. I should come up with something to distract myself with and calm down. Nope. My mind is blank. I can't focus at all. So embarrassing. Mister, are you okay? Yep, I'm doing fine. Oh, is that a Ferris wheel? Hey, Halo, we should go. It looks fun. I love Ferris wheels. Maybe he's trying to distract himself, too. Might as well play along. Yeah, sure, but maybe we should leave the best for last. Everything will probably look amazing in the evening, but I'll be paying for it, okay? No funny business, sir. You already paid for the shooting stand. Oh, thanks? Come on, then. Let's go. With that in mind, we start trying out attractions that catch our eyes and interest. Some were really amusing and calm, while others were really exciting and thrilling to get on. Time passes in the blink of an eye, and it looks like it's finally time for the Ferris wheel. The view up here is a sight to behold. Can we see it? Inside the gondola, we can see everything. Can I see it, please? Whoa, you can actually see the whole city from up here. It's so pretty. And look at all the tiny people down there. Like little ants. Holy crap, we're so high up. Me too. Hey, Halo. Look at all those buildings. They look so small from here. And some random guys, too. Just people watching from the top of the Ferris wheel. Yeah, they do. Everything looks so pretty from up here. Don't you think so, too, mister? Mm-hmm, it does. But your eyes look even more beautiful. Huh? When they are looking good. You know? Me. Oh, God. I almost choked on spit, rest in peace. Me too. I felt bad. I burst out laughing. For a moment there, Mr. really got my heart skipping a beat until he fluked it with adorable goofiness. I'm gonna choke. Help. I am now dying. Officially. Oi! Okay. I'm not dying. I just wanted to try acting like a boyfriend, since this is one of those cliche places you can be with your significant other. Yeah, I realized it too. Oh, the fun fair was so nice. Oh yeah, by the way, Mr. looks so happy when he's making the little plush wave at me. This combo should be illegal. I agree. I decided to give it a name. Halo, meet Mistake. Mistake, meet Halo. Let's all get along, yeah? When you're a mistake. You named your prize Mistake. But why? No. My steak. With Mistake. Like, a Y. Like, Mista. You know, Mista. Mistake. And also, I had fun today. I'm not the most social or extroverted person out there, but you helped me come out of my shell and enjoy the world a little more, so. This is for you. And Mister hands over Mistake to me. The cute plush is extremely soft to the touch. I would like to hold, with cute eyes that look very bright. I want to hold it. Let me hold the Mistake. And no, I don't have a return policy. It's yours forever and ever. For me, the prize he won through his shooting skills, that he said were crap, that he even named is mine now. Wow! Thank you so much. I'll treasure it. I'll make sure Mistake is happy. Take very good care of it. And I had a lot of fun hanging out with you, too. It was really lovely, so really, thanks, mister. The Ferris wheel begins to descend, and the two of us watch the watercolor-esque sunset. Mr. Stanley speaks. You know, about your question earlier about why I became a detective? It's because I was always told that I'm a natural-born genius, and I didn't want to waste that. So here I am now, solving cases and doing my best to help people. I don't think I'm that great, so yeah. Let's just talk about stuff that's more interesting. No, I actually like hearing more about you. But if it's too much right now, it's okay too. Don't feel pressured by me in any way, Mr. Vista. He gives me a gentle smile and leaves it at that.
I wish we could have seen the scenery. What the?
After getting out of the gondola, we chat a bit on the way home about random things that come to mind and end up falling into a comfortable silence while enjoying the scenery.
Also, I wish we could have talked about folklore with Ike. That would have been amazing. Oh, wait. I wonder if later to the game you do get to talk about folklore, because there's no way you can write Ike in like any sort of game, especially like a dating sim, without mentioning Hatsune Miku at one point. That's not how this works.
And just have player be a Vocaloid fan. If you watch Ike and you do not like Vocaloid, truly, what are you? You are not Quildren. We do not claim you. I'm joking, of course. The setting sun tints its surroundings with a lovely auburn hue. It truly is a wonderful day. Sorry, mister, but I can't stop thinking about moments where you're really cool and ones that where you were cringe. But like I said before, today was fun.
Hey! We're not talking about them.
But yeah, it was for sure fun. Maybe we could hang out again sometime.
I'd like to, but I'll let you know when I'm less busy, alright?
Sure. Where do you want to meet next time? Mr. grins at my enthusiastic answer. Glad I'm not the only one who is looking forward to our next outing.
Of course, today was a lot, but everything was really fun.
So I'll make sure to set aside some time for our next meeting.
Aw, thank you.
But let's just find time where we're both free. You don't want to make Lucas sad.
Oh, and to make our lives easier, how about exchanging numbers? That way we can just message each other when we have some free time.
Of course, you're allowed to send me messages that don't involve time.
Aside from the fact that you're being flirty again, I agree that it is a good idea to exchange numbers.
After we each whip out our phones, we exchange numbers and immediately greet each other with lots of emojis. Our DM looks as if we've been talking to one another for years. Anyway, before we stand here and spam each other endlessly, how about we both go home and enjoy some good quality sleep? I think I'll sleep really well tonight. Oh yeah, I haven't really slept without crying myself into it for a long time.
Oof!
Halo, please don't take this seriously, I was just kidding. For some reason, I slightly doubt that. Laughing about his bizarre joke, we finally bid each other goodbye and head home. I haven't walked this much for a long time, I'm pretty tired. But even so, today was so much fun. I'm happy that I got to spend some time with Mista. My feet would have hurt so much, bro. It was really nice seeing so many sides of him, especially his cute side. Wait, I'm doing it again. I can't think of Mista like that, can I? With new thoughts swirling in my mind of Mista and the fun we had today. Cat, hello? Okay, bye. I go home and take a much-needed rest. I hug the plushie close to my chest as my consciousness begins to slip away, fading into a peaceful slumber.
Oh, yeah.
The music is such a bop. All right. Now to continue on, we shall go shoes route for the next. Color. I wonder if it's dyed. Is it a trend to have yellow fringe that looks like a banana these days? He looks like a well-mannered with that suit though. The banana. It's banana. Haha. Wait, it actually does kind of look like bananas. I never actually realized that. I just kind of was like, oh, it's like wild extensions. But no, I never actually like process the oh hey, it looks like bananas. I can't believe I never thought about that. it's that boy. Oh, she, what up? Coca-Cola. Banana. Banana. Definitely pecan soup spoon, just like me. Woohoo, we are one and the same. Alright. They're pretty interesting. It would be fun to get fun getting to know them. The minions will be fed. Will they? Will they? Oh wait, no, his hair is going straight down, not like around the, shoulder like he usually does. I just realized that. But hey, the Yeminians are not starving for once. Oh my god, you guys are not skin and bone. Yeah. I am rooting for you guys. I am proud of all of you. Also, I love the tie. The tie with the little clip is so cute. What the? Me on my way to look at the files of the game just to see the artwork and see if they have any. Wait, what does he have to say for Shu? I must know. I feel okay, so this would be Vox, this would be Mista, this would probably be Shu, of course Ike, and then that sounds like something Luca would say. Especially since, in order, it's always been Fox, Mista, Shu, Ike, Luca, Solga. Can you please tell me more about the writer of this note? He looks intimidating at first, but that's for sure. I mean, he's the manager that, yeah, there we go, that every employee here loves. But once you get to know him more, perhaps you'll see a side of him that not everyone gets to see. More laid back? Maybe. Needless to say, he's the whole package. That's pretty much all I know about them. Do you need anything else, or are you ready to pick now? Oh wait, I think I get it. The dark. I think I could understand how to like be. Yes, this is Shu because dark Yami. Ha 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 ha. Or is just that just coincidence? How much you want to bet that's coincidence? And I'm looking way too deep into it. Have fun doing whatever you're doing. Itchy. Should I talk to it? Yes. Man with the curious hair. There he is. Alright. Remembering the familiar hair colored hair that I previously saw, I thought it would be a good idea to approach him first. Weird hair, dude. You must be the new recruit. Halo, right? Love how it just goes from Banana Man to Weird Hair Dude. Give me more names. I would like to know what else you would call them. I'm Shiomino, the manager of Lion's Pride. I've heard a lot about you, especially from Luke, boss. Okay, so when we first meet him on the last part, we get the same thing. Okay, so, yeah. You're the manager? Should I call you Mr. Yomino then? I hope I wasn't rude. Don't worry, just call you. I have a good feeling that it's well liked by our colleagues. Was that said last time? I can't remember. Eventually, the manager leaves to deal with some work. I still have some time left. Who should I talk to? We'll go Luca this time. Slightly nerve-wracking to be put on the spotlight in a few conversations, but I can't help but feel even more nervous when I spot my boss starting to approach me, a wide smile on his face. That cannot be good. I'm kidding. Oh, Halo, you made it! Of course, you invited me. Hey, you don't need to be so shy around me. Okay. See, you're getting all shy now. I guess it'll take a while for you to be comfy around me, huh? So, is anyone bullying you? He protect, he attack, but most importantly, he like Pringle snack. No, everyone has been so kind to me. good. If anyone's billing you, let me know. So I can join in on the join in on the fun. If anyone is bullying you, let me know so I can join in the fun. What do you mean? I'm just joking. Luca on his way to just bully the player, just casually. I will leave you be. Talk to you later, Halo. Boss runs off quickly, greeting the new guest with the same energy he greeted me with. I can't help but chuckle at this. It's best to leave him and move on. I think I've just enough time for one more conversation. Who should I talk to? We're gonna try and yeet. As I look around, I spot Shu in the crowd, seemingly free at the moment. Taking the opportunity, I walk towards him. Oh, hey, it's nice to see you again. Did you need something? Well, I wanted to ask if I could get to know you more. So, Ike, we don't get to see a little bit of a flustered face, but Shu, we do. You know what? That's okay. That's okay. I accept it. Because, haha, we win. I mean, wow, that's pretty straightforward of you. Understandable, have a great day. I mean, it's not really appropriate to pry into someone's business that quickly. How dare you? We aren't in a rush either, are we? You know what, I got no rebuttal for that one, I'm sorry. I was trying to think of a comeback, but I have none. But if you want to know me better, maybe we can start talking more. I'm always here, so feel free to just stop by. That sounds plausible. I look forward to seeing you more often then. We talk a little more until he's called by someone to help out with the cabaret. He bids me goodbye for the time being before leaving to help them out. As I lay on my bed, I suddenly... Okay, yeah, it's the same conversation over and over and over again. Skip. Good morning, Shu. Oh, yeah. Good morning, Halo. Good luck with work today. Shu always looks so calm and collected. It's honestly admirable. Can confirm, I cannot relate to the calmness. Because I cannot be calm when I'm tired. Cat, are you good? You too. I walk away, heading off to serve tables. It's still the early hours of the workday, so there shouldn't be too many people, right? Ha! You thought. Aww. That would've been funny if it's just ha-ha, but in reality, it was a lot of people. My assumption was right. Everything was going smoothly. There aren't a lot of people. The atmosphere is comfortable. Or at least it was until this happened.
Oh, no!
Okay, but I like the random people's outfits. Like, they all seem to have the same outfit, but it looks so good. It looks like this epic. It's a bop. 11 out of 10 would look at again. What is the meaning of this? You got my order wrong. I can't believe the Lion's Pride has stooped this so low. They're hiring people like you, bro. I'm new to the job. Give me a minute. This is a Karen at a retail store, bro. Never even worked retail. Ha! Well, I didn't know. I would have so gone. Well, I didn't know. That's the first thing I'm gonna say if I gotta see this. I would have so gone, well, I didn't know, route. Just to be like, what do you expect me to know everything? Do you expect me to be perfect? You know how many times McDonald's messes up orders, bro? I'm sorry, I didn't know that you had special instructions for this drink. I come here often, there's no such thing as not knowing. There is if you're a new worker, good sir. Why did your boss not tell you about me? Perhaps because you don't actually matter in life, but you know. That's just my thought. I'm a valued customer, so you should have known. Well, I don't even know your name. Your name is Woman. Be quiet. At least you know how to apologize. Well, now I'm not going to. Maybe next time, don't make such a stupid mistake. I can't even get a word in. I'm at a loss, unable to say anything. She abuses every reason I provide her with, using the meanest of insults, too. I don't know if I can keep going. Come to her rescue, thank you very much. But just then, just when I thought that everything was hopeless appears, a slim but reassuring hand slowly and protectively positions me behind him. It's Shu. He looks collected, as if he's already prepared for this to happen. Ayo. I'll take care of this, Halo. Please stay behind me. And make sure not to make a sound. Okay. Why do they have employees as bad as this one? Look at you, you're so much better than them. What's your name? Yamina? I deeply apologize for this mishap. I'll make sure your order is correct next time, madam, I assure you. We'll train our poor employees better to make sure that nothing like this happens again, but please refrain from taking out your anger on them. Lion's Pride thanks you for your continued patronage, ma'am, madam, and we're always happy to welcome you back to our humble cabaret. Get rid of that idiot.
No.
The woman seems content with this answer, sitting back down with her legs crossed. She still has this bit of expression on her face, glaring holes into me. Shu notices this and pats my arm gently, signaling me to hide further behind him. I'll arrange for your drink to be remade, so just sit right there. And Halo, may I speak to you in private? Follow me. Shu? He doesn't wait for a response, dragging my wrist as we walk through the crowds and into the staff areas. The thought runs in my head, what if I angered him? What if we lose a valued customer because of me?
Y'all would lost a valued customer with my actual answer. I would have been, well, I'm sorry I didn't know. You do realize you're not that special, right?
I hang my head down, ashamed. The only thing I can think of, I can see, is the floor moving in front of me and the back of Shu's feet. He doesn't say anything either. We're in complete silence. It's almost like torture. Not knowing what would happen. I hate that so much, dude. Thank God the break room isn't that far. But I can feel my heart sinking. What if I'm about to be reprimanded? What if he's angry at me? These thoughts are so true, bro. After all, he is my manager. There isn't any other reason that he would bring me here, right? Perhaps to calm you down. A good manager would do that, especially if he knows you're not in the wrong. We're here. Go ahead and take a seat. Okay. Are you feeling okay? That customer was a bit rough with their words. I'm alright. But your expression says otherwise. It's fine, really. These things do happen, after all. There's a moment of silence between the two of us as I try to hold a strong face in front of Shu. It seems like it didn't work. He looks even more concerned now compared to before. And with a sigh, he starts speaking to me again. I'll call a little break for you. 20 minutes should be enough. Just to clear off some steam, of course. It's not good to work in your condition right now. I'm not doubting your feelings, but you really don't look right. Okay, no, I'll be fine. We'll go, okay. Just don't put up any more of a fight. Okay. Alright then. I'll grab you something to drink, so wait here. Shu leaves the room, the door closing ever so gently. His footsteps fade out from my hearing, and the silence in the room is suffocating. The only things I could hear are my thoughts running wild and the beating of my heart. How did I make that mistake in front of everyone, too? Maybe I really am not suited for this job. What did Lucas see in me to hand me this job so easily? Even Shu looked mad. God. I feel the door open behind me, Shu's figure re-entering the room. He's holding two cups, one in each hand. Ah, sweet, is it tea? Can I have sweet tea or green tea? Green tea would be good. Sweet tea preferably, but green tea is also nice, especially pure leaf green tea. Pure leaf green tea, 11 out of 10, would taste again. I wonder how he opened the door, though. Pushing it open with his body, his leg, the mystery. Truly the mystery. Definitely. Hey, I'm back. I didn't know what to bring you, so I brought some orange juice and water. Just pick whichever you want. I originally wanted to make you some drinks, but Uki rejected my idea of making some Tilk. I want to assume Tilk is tea and milk, because I don't know any other drink that starts with tea. Well, okay, so technically, a lot of people do actually put milk in tea. I've done that before. When I had little tea parties as a little kid, I'd put some little bits of milk in tea. It actually tasted good. So, why am I pointing to the camera and, like, using hand body language when I don't even have, like, I don't have the hand motion tracking for my mod, whatever. Anyways, it's better than Pilk, I'll give you that. Better than Pilk. I'm sorry, what? Tilk, where you mix some tea and milk. But that's actually kind of good, though. From what younger me knows. That is just milk tea, huh? It's Tilk. No, he's right, it is Tilk. It's not just milk tea. Milk tea is an entirely different thing. Milk tea is more milk and tea. Tilk... Wait, milk tea is just a little bit of milk and tea. Tilk is whole milk and then probably just a little bit of tea. That's what I imagine Pilk is. It's just a lot of milk and then a bit of Pepsi. That's about it. We have Kilk. Coke and milk. Ugh, sounds disgusting. My nanny makes this alcoholic drink, but she uses ginger ale. She didn't have ginger ale at one point, so she had to use Coke. She was like, never again. He coughs lightly, perhaps to clear the air or to ease the embarrassment he's feeling. All I know of him is when he is serious at work. So it's refreshing to see him like this. To cheer you up. An aura appears around Shu as a violent flame grows around his palm. The flame sprouts a glint of yellow, revealing a floating piece of paper that resembles a human. It's filling circles around Shu, and it looks very happy to see me. It's called a paper shikigami. Cute, right? My grandma used to do this all the time when I fell down, so I figured it'd help you too. I reach out my hand, trying to catch his attention. Once he sees me, the paper shikigami starts to float around my hand, nuzzling into my fingertips. It feels like silk, slipping through my fingers, traveling its way to my cheeks, and giving me a light peck. Stop it, it tickles. This fella's so playful. She silently watches the both of us and lets out a gentle smile. It really is thoughtful. It's an adorable sight, where the shikigami excitedly floats around me like a puppy at its owner. That's okay to make mistakes, you know? That's how we grow. So, don't let this beat you down, okay? Just keep doing your best. A smile suits you better, Halo. Thank you, Shu, for cheering me up and stepping in back there. I'm sorry I messed up, but I promise to do better next time. I hope you're not too mad at me. Shu chokes a bit. There's a small pause where he puts down his drink before looking at me in shock. Shoot, my judgment was wrong. Why did I say that when he's never shown any signs of being mad? Halo, why are you like this? Why are you the way that you are? Mad? Why would I be mad at you? To be honest, I'm kind of mad at the customer. I get why she's upset, but she really went too far with her words. You're new. It's understandable that you make mistakes here and there. I was the same when I just started working here. So don't stress yourself too much over it. Okay, thank you. No problem. Remember, you can rely on me anytime. Dang, that was it? I feel like that one's the shortest we've had so far. Alright. Wait, I need to see the other option. Well, I didn't know. You didn't tell me when you ordered. Wait, no, how would I... Whatever. I come here often. There is no such thing as not knowing. Yeah, there is. With that attitude, how dare you? You're so rude. I hope you get fired. I hope your life subscription gets canceled, bro. I can't even get a word in. Okay, same thing. Okay, so same thing pretty much. How do you not even know the manager's name, bro, if you're like a regular here? Like, if you're a valued customer. Hello, my Phoebe. He's resting his head on my foot. Like, if you are a valued customer here, if you are a common customer here, you are a regular, how do you not know the name of the manager? Like, I'm kind of concerned. No, we will not be getting rid of that idiot. I'm a good idiot. Ha ha! Okay, so, will he have a different answer, different response to how I acted? I need to know. Okay, same things. I'll be fine, don't worry. But
you say so. I won't force you to do anything. Be careful, right? It's nothing really. I can handle it myself.
Shu seems surprised at my quick response, fumbling around a bit, looking as if there's more he wants to say, but eventually decides against it. After a short contemplation, he smiles at me. Alright, please take care. I only nod at Shu and leave the station to resume my work. During my shift, I can feel someone looking at me. When I check behind me, I realize that's Shu. He gives me a light nod and goes back to his station, but I can't seem to shake off the feeling that his smile wasn't genuine this whole time. He really does care about his colleagues, huh? Well, that's probably why he's favored amongst everyone here. Well, back to work it is.
Oh, there's more! Okay! Okay! I see it!
For some reason, I felt like it was going to just stop right there. Never mind, I take the bag. Oh, Fiddly, you're just so comfy, aren't you? The Feep, he is very comfy. I need to make him a model. The rest of the workday seems normal enough. No troublesome customers, just the usual. Shu seems to be looking after me still. I spotted him in the corner, peeking out to check on me. I already told him I didn't need a break, so why is he so persistent? But was I wrong for declining his offer? After all, he was merely looking out for me. Hello? Oh. My nanny came in to clean the litter box. Waha! Hold on, I accidentally tied a knot. I gotta get it out. There we go. Good work, everyone. Please take care. Halo. Too deep in my thoughts, his voice is tuned out of my head as I turn away from him. I leave the cabaret, ignoring his calls. That's painful. Oh, and there they go.
I'm so sorry.
I found him! Dude, I just sounded like a gremlin. Remember me asking about, hey, they mentioned alter egos. Do you think we'll see Eki anytime soon? We didn't see Eki. But we did see Hikarino. As you can tell, I am biased. Heck yeah. Dude's already made an appearance and we're only on the demo. What the? This is the last thing I expected. What the heck? And I like the color for his name too. Hey, yo. I like the like tealish, greenish color. It's the bigness and nice. Wait, will he have his entire models come up right here? Is he just kind of like invisible?
It seems you're troubled, dear Yamino. What is it now?
I can hear the exasperation. Looking around, Shu makes sure nobody can see him. He looks snazzy. He looks snazzy, even though he's just a coloration difference. But I like the blue. The blue, and it's the same person, but it's a different coloration. What the heck? Once he's conf- once he confirms it's alright, a piece of paper flies out from his pocket, materializing into what appears to be a mirror image of himself.
What the?
Alright, hold on. Alright, sorry, my nanny needed help to get the thingamajiggy in my room for his new thingamajiggy, his new little box. There we go. And then I put my bowl away, so haha! Anyways, image of himself. The man stands in front of Shu, arms crossed. That's not arms crossed. I don't know if you. Wait, I just realized instead of the pink, it's blue. Dude, I tried to take Shu's, like, character and then, like, invert the colors. It's not that, though. I don't know how y'all got those colors, but anyways. Nothing much, really. Seems like you have a little something, or rather, someone you're looking out for. How cute of you to actively look out for them. Though they don't seem to be the brightest. I don't see why you choose them. But whatever floats your boat, I guess. It has nothing to do with you, Hikarino, so stay out of this. I'm worried for them. I knew they were hurt, but maybe it's worse than I thought. After all, they're new to this job. What if they quit? I would have said something, but you already told me it's none of my business. Too bad, I'm not the type to listen. What I have to say is, don't hurt yourself emotionally. It hurts me too. Hikarino, you care about me? Now we share a vessel, insolent fool. Whatever you do to yourself, I feel it too. Nonetheless, good luck, Yamino. I don't need your luck. Suit yourself, then. Don't say I didn't warn you when things go south. Yeah, whatever. I love the music. The music is bop. With a flick of a finger, the mirror image of him disappears, returning to its original form of a Shikigami doll again. Shu sighs to himself, storing away the doll somewhere safe. Did Halo ignore him on purpose, or was it just an honest mistake? Time will tell.
Ah, yee.
When you get to. Okay, I need to see. I need to see if he says anything about, well, I didn't know. I need to see that. Guess we got this. This is the same. Meow. Oh, the meow meow. It's a little meow meow. Tilk. It is Tilk. It's Tilk. It's Tilk, Your Honor. Alright, so it's pretty much just the same. So yeah, it's all the same. No comment about the, well, I didn't know. Okay, so yeah, it's all the same. Okay, so it's all the same. Rest in peace. Okay, anyways. Do 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 do. Meow. A refined-looking man with dark hair contrasting his snow-white suit and technically skin, if you think about it. His eyes shone amongst the somber lights of the bar. It seems to hold so much wisdom in them. So, why'd you call me over? Same thing, as always. Yep, pretty much. Okay. Monkey. Haha. They left in such a hurry. Poor thing. Are they quite alright? Wait, what is your opinion? What is your opinion on Vox? He has the dreamiest looks and the hottest voice. But from what I observe, he seems to have his ducks in a row. He can most likely handle himself pretty well. Boyfriend material, if you ask me. You are the best person to ask, to be fair, so. That's pretty much all I know about them. Do you need anything else, or are you ready to pick now? Wait, okay, so. Fine, how could I say no? Just don't take ages to pick, okay? Which one do I want to know more about? I would like to see. Did I get his opinion on Mista? Oh, he can be loud at times, but there are moments he tends to be quiet. I can see that he has a gentle heart deep down. I'm not sure if the smile he holds is genuine or not. That's pretty much all I know about them. Okay, there we go. That's it. Oh, they're going now. To the party. The man who's devilishly attractive. I remember the tall man from the group. He didn't talk much, but he has this charismatic aura that makes me want to approach him. Fortunately, I can see him. Devil man.
Devil man!
Ooh, I was watching, rewatching Supernatural yesterday. Childhood, bro. I can't remember what episode Castiel comes in, but I can't wait for him to come back. Yes, that's me. And you are? Oh, how rude of me. I'm terribly sorry. My name is Boxakuma. I'm a friend and a business partner of Luca's. You might remember me from the time he called you over at the cabaret. So that's when I've seen him before. Oh, it's nice to officially meet you, Mr. Akuma. No need for formalities, please. Call me Box. Of course, Box.
How was it easier with him?
Oh, wait, it's because he's a voice demon, isn't it? Yeah, there we go. We can go find him again, right? Yeah, we can. To my To my surprise, a familiar face walks over to me, looking very concerned. Hey, Laura, you alright? Whoa, Vox. Yeah, I'm fine. Just need to step away from the crowd for a bit. I understand. Would you like me to step away? What? No, you're fine, Vox. I want to talk to you and I don't know. Just get to know you a little, if that's okay. Really? Huh, that's nice to hear. I'd like to get to know you as well. I hear a phone ringing once the crowd noises. Based on Vox's reactions, I have a good feeling that it's his. I'm so sorry, I have to take this. It might be a while, but listen. If you ever need someone to talk to, or if you need help with something, I'll be here. I'll be around. Oh, thank you, Vox. I'm looking forward to getting to know you better. Same here. Alright. So he has like the... Okay, anyways. We go to Luca. Skip. I'm not accustomed to working at this bar. The work isn't too overwhelming, and patrons are polite enough. I've even started to remember a few of them, and they've started to recognize me. They're friendly, though at times they can be a bit... Halo, another round of shots over here. Right away. You're looking stunning as always. How about I treat you to a drink? Oh boy, here we go. I think I'll pass for today, Mr. Johan, but thanks. Here are your shots. Crap, I'm so sorry. It's alright, let me clear that up for you, but be careful where you step. Rowdy. I go to the storeroom to grab a broom and come back to start cleaning up the mess. Despite the mundane nature of the task, it's hard to not take the note of the nicely varnished floors. The entire bar is stunning, well furnished with decor, soft lights giving the room a comfortable glow. It makes the job less stressful, and the thought of the late night shifts that would surely come feel less daunting as well. I snap out of my reverie as the tips of my co-worker's shoes come into view. Hey, I can get the rest of it. There's another table over there that needs serving. Oh, thank you. It's no problem. The night goes on, the bar continues to fill with the quiet chatter of its patrons and the gentle clinking of glassware. It's not what I would have expected to be a mafia front, but with Luca as the owner, it shouldn't be all that surprising. Come to think of it, Luca isn't at the bar today. I wonder where he is. Here you are, one frozen strawberry margarita, one rum runner daiquiri, and a classic old-fashioned. Talk to customers, go back to counter. Let's talk to the customers. Is there anything else that I can help you with today? I start putting empty glasses and food plates onto silver trays that's resting on the palm of my hand. We're good for now, thank you. No! Oh no! I found it. So I think I found the part they were actually talking about. David, please, we're in public. I'm so friggin' hungry, I swear to God, if I don't get something to eat right now, I'm going to devour this table. Man said, I'm as hungry as a horse, quite literally. I'm so hungry I could eat a horse, quite literally. There we go, I fixed it. I stand in shock as the drunken man lets his head fall onto the table and start licking it. That's not very sanitary, good sir. His friend grabs the back of his collar and lifts his face off the table. I'm so sorry, Halo. He's wasted right now. David starts violently wailing. Oh, please, David, you just ate 20 entire plates of chicken wings. I don't know how many more wings my wallet can take. That's accurate. We can always order caviar toast if you're hungry, David. Not the caviar toast. David immediately starts crying. Stops crying. No. I am so sorry about all this. Don't worry about it. I work at a bar. It's all part of the job. Here we go. David sharply turns to look at me. From the look on his face, one would think that he just saw God himself. Oh my God, you just look just like my waifu. No. If you ask David, he did see God. I slowly back away from the group of interesting individuals. As I weave through the many tables and chairs in the bar, I am able to catch a glimpse of many supportive and frankly entertaining glances of my co-workers. Then, from a distance, I hear, David, I swear to God, if you ask for chicken wings one more time, I'm going to castrate you. This is my favorite one so far, solely because of this comment alone. I can't help but laugh at the sheer insanity of what just happened. Moments like these are what make my job worthwhile. As I whisk away the empty glasses for cleaning, I notice a familiar figure walking into the bar out of the corner of my eye. I look up and confirm that it's Vox? Oh crap, he don't have his white jacket thingy on. It takes me a moment to recognize him, for his usual calm composure has faded into complete dishevelment. Oh crap, what up? The white suit he seems to favor is gone. Instead, he dons a rumpled white shirt that is partially unbuttoned. That's a red shirt, good sir. At the top, with hints of his collarbones peeking through. Oh, how scandalous. His hair is tossed, faint dark circles ring under his eyes. Me too. Like, honestly, yeah, felt that daily. What the heck happened? As if drawn on a string, I feel myself being pulled towards him. I quickly set aside the empty glasses and turned to head in his direction. Vox has now slumped over the counter with one hand threaded through his hair. Vox, are you okay? You don't look well. He looks up with a clear surprise at being called, and his demeanor shifts. He straightens himself up. I'm alright, Halo. Well, at least you look lovely tonight. Makes me want to come here more often. Well, I would be opposed to the idea. Oh. Since another customer is always good for business. Ah. I see how it is. My ego has been wounded and I am now bleeding out. How could you? It's okay, you're used to this. Oh, just cope. Seriously, though. Are you sure you're okay? Vox's grin fades and his gaze falls. Just business stuff. Nothing to trouble yourself over, Halo. I don't believe you, if you say so. You don't look like you're alright, but I won't pry if you'd rather not talk about it. Yeah. Vox is taken aback for a moment, clear surprise on his face, but his expression soon melts into a soft grin. Thank you, Halo. I appreciate the... I quickly reach into my part... My... That... That was the phone. It was Five Nights at Freddy's Scream, wasn't it? Please tell me it was the FNAF 1 jump scare. Please be the case, because that was one of my alarms for the longest time to wake up in the morning. As well as, that is my alarm to try and wake me up when I'm taking a nap. Doesn't wake me up? No, 9 times out of 10. Instead of sleeping for an hour and 30 minutes, I sleep for 4 hours. Can confirm. Mute my phone notification, slightly embarrassed what just happened. Oh crap, that was loud. I'm so sorry, Vox. The two of us fall awkwardly silent, neither of us muttering a word to the other. I turn to look at Vox. He also turns to look at me. Our eyes meet before he bursts into fits of laughter. That's Five Nights at Folger's, right? Yeah, it was a prank by a friend, but I never bothered changing it back. It kinda grew on me. Is that so? For the longest time, my notification sound used to be Revenant's giggle. Like, just and then I turned it to Ike's little ada ada. Wait, no, I turned it to the aha! Like, if I turn it on, let me just turn it on right now. Although, my ringtone used to be ada ada. People on r/ how girls work be wild and sometimes. At least this person who asks if I'm a renowned mathematician. Bro, I suck at math. I hate math with burning passion. But anyways, I am not getting any notifications right now. I opened up a notification for r/men and females. A new one. And it is. I swear, every anime has the same school rooftop, and it's the picture of the one part of the school rooftop that you see in Gotcha Life. And it says, that's where female girls confess their crushes. And someone responds with, female girls? We got a double whammy, boys. We got female and girls. What other girls are there? Girls are girls, bro. Female or not? Only girls born female confess to their crushes on the rooftop. Obviously, trans girls clearly do not confess their feelings for anyone. Clearly, they do not have feelings for anyone. They are alone forever. Apparently, that's female girls. To be fair, that comment is perfect middle school boy energy, so it feels fitting. No, because even middle school boys know, not female girls. That's there it is. We found it, boys. We got it. I think they couldn't decide between the two terms and just went with both for some reason. My guess is they wrote female students first, then tried to erase and wrote girls instead, but accidentally left one word in, as opposed to male girls or female boys. I think those female girls as opposed to male girls, I think those are called tomboys. Kind of like femboys, but women. I get the feeling that they consider Ito that schools are only for simps to learn at. There are male girls these days, so he's not wrong, bro. Why are you being downvoted? You're right, but trans people exist. It's these days, like trans people haven't been around forever. Very common transphobic talking point, act like people, like trans people are fad. What the heck? Thought of something from the corner of my eye, whatever. Calling a trans woman a male girl is also just misgendering. Precisely, AMAP girl is significantly better way of putting it. Yeah. Alright, anyways. Yeah, that sent me female girls. Wild. What a day to be alive. Oops. Anyways. His tense and tired expression is long gone, now replaced with a curious smile. Seems as if he's waiting for me to elaborate more. They got me hooked onto FNAF. Said something about how they didn't have anyone to talk about the lore. I see. You founded good work. We need more FNAF lore enjoyers, you know? FNAF lore enjoyers? Is that what you call yourself? It's a bit of a goofy title, but please enlighten me about this lore, Mr. Voxakuma. Vox and I engage in a long conversation, sounds about right, about FNAF lore. It's mostly him explaining while I occasionally interrupt to ask questions or make comments. After a few more minutes, Vox's phone lights up from a notification, presumably a text message. Is everything okay? Everything's fine, but my close friend is waiting for me outside. I'm sorry for cutting our conversation short, Hala. I understand. No need to apologize. It was nice talking to you, Vox. And it was a pleasure talking to you too, Hala. We should play FNAF together sometimes, perhaps in VR. Oh no. Don't look at me like that. Come on, Hala. It'll be fun. There we go. Anyways. Fine, how can I possibly say no? Here, may I? Gesturing to his phone, he nods and gives it to you. You save your number and his contacts before giving it back. There you go. You can text me the plans for when you'd like to play together. Thanks. See you, Hala. See you soon. Wait, so do we get to play with him, or is like that until next time? You wave him goodbye as you watch his figure exit the club until he's out of your sight. Oh, never mind. I arrive back home in the early hours of the morning after my shift has ended. Just as I'm about to wind down for bed, I hear my phone shake with a notification. I sit up and grab my phone from where it was charging beside me. The screen lights up, blinding with a blinding flare, and I see written across it, "Hey, are you still awake?" I quickly text back, ignoring the glowing numbers of the clock stating the time. "Yeah, what's up?" "Sorry, I know it's a little late, but I figured you would still be up." I watch the Vox's typing fade and then return. "Can I call you? Would that be alright?" "Accept, refuse." "Bruh, I hate calls, but for your sake, I'll accept." Oh my god! Bro, I wish I could draw like that. I only wish. Oh, the little monkey plushie, the little monkey. It's a nice looking bed, by the way. In the few seconds between his last text and the first ring of my phone, I wonder what it is that's kept him up, and whether it had been the same thing bothering him earlier that night. I pick up the phone. "Hello?" "Yellow." "Hey. Vox, what's wrong? You okay? Sorry to bother you so late, or, well, early, I guess." He laughs a little nervously. "No, it's late because I haven't gone to bed yet. It is not the next day until I go to sleep." He laughs a little nervously. His voice is deeper than what I was expecting. I can't help but feel my heart lurch a little at sound. It like negatively or positively? But that feeling subsides once I notice the same trace of exhaustion still present from before. I hold the phone a little closer to my ear. It's alright. Is something wrong?" A small pause. "Yeah, I guess so. I don't know if I wanted to talk to you about it, but it honestly feels a little silly, but..." "No, it's alright. You can talk to me." A silence hangs for a moment as he considers his words. "There are these new talents that entered the company, and they're going through all the nerves and anxieties that come with it, and I'm trying to offer as much support as I can, but it feels like I can't do much." I hear a sharp exhale from the other end of the line, and then there's people nitpicking over everything they do, like vultures picking at new meat, and the kindred doesn't know how to handle that yet. It's just such a mess. "It's not your fault. Continue to listen." "It's my responsibility to lead. These people look up to me. I'm the figurehead, and..." "Vox, you really care for them, don't you?" "Of course I do. They're everything to me. I watched them grow, you know. Quite literally, for some of them." "Ah, you should have seen them, Halo. Even before the agency was formed, they never failed to grow and surprise me with their skills and talents. It's truly inspiring to watch them grow." The smile and pride in his tone makes my heart melt. "Shut up." "I bet they miss me. I can't wait to go home." "Home? I usually don't stay in the city. We have dormitories for the talent staff. It's a little ways from here. We call it the Akuma Castle." "Ah! Oh, I should bring you there sometime. It's something you would like, then, if that's something you would like, that is." "I'd love to go. If you have me, I want to see the place you call home." "Oh. Nothing, just thank you, Hala." I'm about to say something when I get a sudden urge to yawn. Looks like someone's getting sleepy. Sorry for keeping you up, Hala. Good night, and thank you." "It's okay. It was nice talking to you. Good night, Vox." I turn off my phone and lay back in the bed. The exhaustion of the day finally hits me all at once and sinks deep into my bones. With the comfort of my own bed and the warmth of my blankets wrapped around me, there is nothing I could do to stave off sleep as it takes me in its embrace. Me too felt that. Okay, now it's Luca's turn. Skip. help but stare at his tattoos, though. The tattoos are really cool, though. Wait, I feel like some of it kind of looks like the Luxian logo, almost. Anyways. Alright. It's thanks to him that I got the job. He just seems so different from what I expected him to be. So, why'd you call me over, boss? It's the same thing, as always. Go figure. Hello? Cat? Hello? How may I help you? There he is. I found him. I want to see what he has to say about Luca. Wait, what did I say? Well, this person, he's a boss, need I say more? He's like a golden retriever, complete himbo vibes, and an absolute blast to be around. We all think the same thing, we all have the same thought process. Alright, same thing, pretty much. Okay, yeet. We already know all this. We'll go back to Luca. After a few more conversations with the co-workers, I notice Luca suddenly approaching me again. But this time, he's grinning as if he has a plan in mind. Ayo. Hey. Sorry, Halo, your confused face is kinda cute. Eh? Luca didn't stop laughing, making me puff my cheeks in frustration and confusion. What was this guy thinking? Yeah, okay. Stop laughing at me, Luca. Ayo, you finally called me Luca! Pog! My eyes widened in shock of the realization of what I've done. Oh dear god. No, sorry, boss. Me too. It's okay, Halo. I've said this before. I want you to be comfortable around me. So how's the party so far? Pretty pog, right? It's been pretty fun. Thank you for inviting me. The pleasure's mine, Halo. Luca looks like he has more to say, but in the distance I can hear someone calling for him. I have to go again. Sag. I'll talk to you later though. Bye-bye. Alright, bye boss. And there he goes again. Oh well, can't be with the same person always. There you go. You want a bet? He did say we'll talk again later anyway. I think I have enough time for one more conversation. Who should I talk to? It is Eichel. I like how his glasses posh guy. Okay, pretty much the same thing. Yeah, nothing different. And then we already know this conversation. It's been a week, but looking back at it, talking with Luca during that party was really fun. I know he's my boss, but he always encourages me to be more comfortable around him, and he's really fun to be with outside of work. Speaking of work, just before I started my shift, I heard from Uki that I was assigned to work tomorrow, Saturday. My sweet weekend! Oh well, it should be fun anyways. After my shift, I prepare my things to end the workday. Right before I leave, though, Uki calls and motions me over to where he was. He's resting his head on his hand, elbow leaning over on the counter. So how was your first week? Oh, it's been really fun. Everyone's so nice. Dang, I need to tell the guys to bully you. Or maybe someone in particular. Okay, I'm just joking, you brat. Oh, look at the time. Thank God I won't be seeing your face for the next 2 days. Shoot, go home. He's just go away. Uki waves with a sheepish smile on his face as I turn to leave. What did he mean by someone in particular? We all know. What do you mean? As I'm about to leave, I find Luca by the door talking. Oh my god, his face. Talking with a man I have never seen before. He looks so offended. Why is he offended? Yum, yum. Luca seems serious, but when the man leaves, he turns to see me. Aw, so it wasn't anything negative, okay. The expression on his face instantly shifts, all happy and positive like a golden retriever. Simile. Luca makes his way towards me and ruffles my hair. I pat on him for messing it up, but smile back afterwards. His smile is really contagious. Halo, Halo, hello, hello, how are you doing? I hope everyone has been treating you nicely. Yes, everyone is really nice, aside from Oop, who calls me a brat and wants people to bully me, but that's okay, I will accept it. Also, sorry for the short notice about tomorrow. You really don't mind coming in? No, it's okay, I had nothing planned anyway, and I enjoy being here. Well, I did have something scheduled already, but work is work. No good way. Luca smiles, a face full of relief. He suddenly hugs me tight and pulls me up. Pog! Boss, put me down, please. People are looking. Luca laughs as he starts spinning with me. I try to release myself from him, but he's too strong. Dude, if you try to release yourself while he's spinning, you might just fly through a window, I'm just saying now. Eventually, he finally puts me down, not dizzy nor tired from the stunt he just pulled. Me too. His suit still looks impeccable, while my clothes and hair look like an absolute mess, my vision a little blurry. But I can hear the chattering of the customers and some staff. That man was really energetic, huh? Except for him, okay, they look quite roughed up. I can just hear, like, you're a lifesaver, Halo. Thank you so much. You're the best. Don't forget to bring your ID card with you, okay? Also, make sure you're not overworking yourself or anything. Your health comes first. Luca runs off to his office before I can even say the word pog. Hello. I sigh, smiling unconsciously, and finally heading home. I'm home. Hello? I didn't even know we had a roommate. Hey, Halo, how was your day? Tiring as usual. I had to entertain a lot of orders and deal with different attitudes. How about you? Same. Do you have plans for this weekend? Oh, I'll be going to the cabaret. What? I thought you have weekends off. I do. It's only been a week and they're overworking you already? No, everyone is nice to me. Besides, we don't have enough staff to help tomorrow, so I'm glad I can help. But enough of that. I bought food. Have you eaten? No, thank God you brought food, because I'm famished. The two of us enjoy ourselves for the night, playing horror games and eating good food. However, with how exhausted I am, I can register is pizza and animatronics. Oh, okay, so this is supposed to be the person that introduced us to the FNAF. Oh, it seems like they passed out. Oh, well, I feel exhausted too. Oh, I hope Luca gets home safe. And then snores. Oh, sweet, during the day. It doesn't take long before I reach Lion's Pride. However, when I arrived, I noticed that there isn't anyone except the guard. That's weird. There were normally the staff members before me. Maybe they're deep inside? That could explain it. Good morning, sir. I am here for my shift today. The guard looks down at me with a serious expression, raising an eyebrow. I quickly take out my ID from my pocket and show it to him. His mood changes afterwards and smiles, gently handing me back the ID. Hello, Halo. Boss is waiting for you inside. Oh, Luca's here? Thank you, sir. I'll be going in then. Have a nice day. Oh, yo, it looks nice. It looks like kind of dim. Wait, I think, doesn't it look the same? It feels like it slightly looks a little bit different. Now that I'm inside, I don't notice anybody else, and everything looks so clean, as if nobody was around. Where is everybody? I'm so occupied with my own thoughts, I don't notice someone walking towards me, and... Bah! Hey, yo! I gotcha. I scared the heck out of you, didn't I? Yes, you did. Oh my god. I'm sorry. I couldn't help myself there. You just look so easy to scare right there in the moment. I'm trying to calm my nerves while Luca's calming himself down from laughing so hard. Once my nerves calm down and Luca stops laughing, I notice Boss kneeling down to pick up something circular on the ground near me before standing and handing it over to me. Ah, I think you dropped this though. Oh yeah, that's mine. It is mine. Thank you for noticing in this dark. I wouldn't have forgiven myself if I lost this. Wait, what is it? I didn't even notice that it dropped, thank goodness. I need to secure it better. It's important to me, after all. What is the round thing? I'm sorry for scaring you. I didn't know that this would happen. Please forgive me. No, it's really okay, boss. I'm thankful that at least dropped here and not while I was walking to the cabaret. I'd be in a state of panic if I found out that I lost it, so thank you so much for finding it. He looks at my pendant, with a look I can't quite decipher, but it disappears in mere seconds. No need to thank me. I'm glad everything is well. It seems like that pendant is really important to you, huh? It looks really cute, too. Oh, so kind of like my, tag, my class tag. Whenever I go anywhere, I'm wearing that thing all the time. Thanks, and it is. My father told me that this was a family heirloom passed down from my great-great-great-grandfather. I think it might have been even greater-grandfather, but a family heirloom nonetheless. A golden retriever paw print pendant as a family heirloom? What about it? I know it's a bit unusual, but it is what it is. And aren't there other weirder family heirlooms out there? I'm sure there are. Lucas smiles and pats my head. I feel like a kid when he does that. I don't think that a pendant with the golden retriever paw is weird. It's Pog. Very Pog indeed. Just like your reactions. They're all so cute. Boss! Aw, you look even cuter when you're pouting. My cheeks hurt from smiling, but I have to try and play the bad cop. I can't let him get his way all the time. Boss, stop before I get mad. You don't want to see me when I get mad. For real. Oh, you're getting Madge. Madge. Well, you should know that I am your mean and evil boss. Are you sure you want to snap at your own boss like that? I notice that Luke is trying his best to look mean and evil. It's not working, but I try to sound scared. Oh my god, I'm so sorry, boss. I will behave. Just kidding, Halo. I'm not your boss today. Therefore, there are no real consequences this time. Anyway, what is the plan for the day? I'm pretty curious. What do you mean, boss? I thought I was supposed to work today. Nah, that was a cover-up story. A cover-up story? What for? A cover-up story? So you called me in for nothing? Is this a joke? No. I guess you could say it was because I wanted to spend more time with you. That way I can get to know you more, yeah? I look at him, not sure how to react. In a way, I'm not mad since I had nothing better to do, and I needed to touch grass from time to time. But I can't help but feel bad for the poor soul that's just standing outside. And hanging out with my boss? Isn't that a bit weird? Well, I can take advantage of the situation and bully him for this. Oh, so this was all a mean and evil scheme to get to know me better, huh? I mean, if you were like that... Luke then starts to realize what he said, his face visibly a warmer shade than a few seconds ago, but I can't help but laugh. I didn't mean anything other than that. You're making me flush... How do you say that? Flushes here? I don't know how to say that. You definitely did. Maybe, maybe not. I ask Luca for permission to make us some drinks, to which he agrees. He takes a seat as I prepare a chocolate drink for me and a glass of water for Luca. How dare you? I take both of the glasses and place them on the table, sitting across from him. Wait, just a glass of chocolate? Oh, just a chocolate drink. So chocolate milk. Okay. Just say that, just chocolate milk. Thanks, Halo, I was really thirsty. Anyway, how was your first week here at Lion's Pride? Enjoying the work? As I said, the people here are really nice. Uki is always teasing me, but he's also lending me a hand whenever I need help. And Shu is always patient with me. He's quite a nice manager to have. That's good, that's good. Tell me if someone's bullying or hurting you. I'll be there in a flash. Like wham! Why, you'll join them? Of course, it's the duty of the most evil and meanest boss out there. Nah, just kidding. I'll be there to protect you. A genuine smile flashes on Luca's face as he says this, and it makes my mouth twitch upwards as well. How can one's smile be so contagious? And here, I thought you were going to join them. Who would have thought the one who teases me the most is the one who will come and save me? I mean, I could tease you whenever, but that will be my own personal agenda. What do you mean? What are you getting at? Don't worry. More importantly, I want more info about you, Halo. Yeah, that was a quick topic change there. How come? Me too, though. I do that too. Like I said, I want to know more about you. I see. Sure, why not? We start conversing about random topics about each other. While he learns about my interests, I learn about his, such as his love for cheddar cheese chips. Me too. I love cheddar cheese Pringles and the cheddar sour cream, Ruffles. The game he's addicted to, and the instruments he can play. The only thing we have in common is our hatred for bugs. So, How about the city? I hear you're new here. I am. There are a lot of beautiful cafes and parks here, and the parks here are well kept. Oh, actually, that reminds me. We could walk around the park sometimes. Especially when the weather is nice like today. That's a lovely idea. But have you ever been to the best place in the city? No, you're making me really curious here. What is it? Where is it? Here, right beside me. Okay, that was so cringe. Okay, listen. I don't even know what came over me. What are you even saying, Luca? Hey, you actually called me by my name. I'm glad. I'm sorry. It just seemed like right at the moment. I really don't know what came over me. Halo, I told you that I want you to be more comfortable around me, so this is great. Anyway, we've spent enough quality time for today, and I need to attend to some of my personal errands. Thank you for your time, I really appreciate it. Me too, Luca. Thanks for inviting me. It was fun. Yeah, I had fun. Take care on your way home, okay? Oh, well, thank you. It actually seems like we really just talked the whole day, though it didn't feel like that long at all. I think I'm getting a bit more comfortable talking to Luca as Luca, not as my boss. He really is a fun person to hang out with and is really easy to get close to, even if he keeps teasing me quite a lot. But I guess this is what makes him him. A big, lovable golden retriever whom I call my boss. Yo! It looks so nice. It's such a nice room. Look at the lion over there. Yo, it looks so good. Oh my god. Getting to know Halo is a lot of fun. I'm glad they had a good time, too. Though, that pendant, it definitely seemed familiar. Ooh. Lore. Lots of lore. 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 Ayo. Ayo. What? We getting lots of lore, bro. We getting background. We getting everything in life. We probably shouldn't stay out too late, Luca. It's dark out already. I know. I'm just looking for my pin. It fell off earlier when we were playing. A bright object in the mud attracts Luca's attention after what feels like an eternity of searching. Hey, what's that over there? He extends his hand and begins to dig up the item. After all the dirt has been cleared, Luca clutches what appears to be a broken pendant in his hand. Huh? Is that a dog tag? I'm not too sure. It's broken. A piece of it is missing. It's too bad. It would have been a nice accessory to wear. You could wear it either way, even if it is broken. I'm sure I've seen it before, but Halo said it's a family heirloom. It's just so strange. I must have been mistaken. Either that, or I'm going insane. I should go get some sleep. I've got an early morning ahead of me. Dang, that was a bop. That was good. I think we did everything. Yeah, we did everyone we could get. We got Ike, Mr. Shu, Vox, and Luca. Okay. Oh, that's nice. Well, that was a good demo. I think so far, it seems like. I think Mista's is the longest so far. Or Shu's. Shu is even more interesting with the Hikarino one. So, when the actual game comes out, I'm probably gonna end up doing that, like, doing that route of just to see Hikarino again. Although, I can't wait to see if we see some, like, Eki. That would be 11 out of 10 right there. They all are really interesting, though. I really like this. I definitely like it. It's so good. Hold on, let's just... I hate when it does this. Hello? Give it a moment. It's being stupid. Hello?
Hello.
Alas, I am stuck in here. Is it back yet? Finally, it is back. Alright. Well, why is my head always turned this way? Can I fix that at all? Whatever. Anyways. So, it's good so far. I like all their stories. I like Mista's with the fox. I like the fox. I want the fox. I also like Ike's. I just don't like that it made it awkward when I laughed at him, because I would genuinely do that. I would genuinely laugh at someone for falling. That'd be funny. And I'm like, are you good? And then help them up. But anyways, to each their own. I really like the little CG art of Vox when he calls the player. That was really nice. Also the David. That was funny. I really like Shoes especially, both the route where you insist you're fine and the route where you don't give him a hard time, you're just like, alright, fine. I really like that one. Lucas is also good, especially with the little flashback we have of like the unknown like dog tag thing. Which is funny, when I mentioned my class tag, that's actually really ironic. And yeah. I can't wait to see more of Ike's especially. I can't wait till the full game comes out, which is in what, 2023? Yeah, March 2023. It seems like it'll take forever, but in reality, it ain't gonna be that long, boys. Let's see, December, January, February, March. That's 3 months, dude. That's, I think, a little less than 3 months, actually, depending on the day. So, I can't wait for that. You best know I'm gonna be here, and you best know I'm gonna stream that. So, can't wait for that. But yeah, I'm liking it so far. I love all the art. The art is absolutely gorgeous. And yeah, I can't wait. I'm excited. I've been excited since I saw something about, like, Luxium Dating Simulator. I was like, wait, Luxium Dating Simulator? Count me in, bro. I gotta see this. So yeah, I definitely like it. It's definitely very nice. And 11 out of 10. They definitely clearly worked very hard on this. And I'm glad they gave, like, let you choose, like, let you put your own name. And also, especially, let you choose the pronouns you are referred to as. That's very nice. I haven't really seen that in many dating sim type games before. So that's a really good refresher. It's really refreshing to have. So I appreciate that. They all definitely clearly put a lot of effort into this, and I wish I knew how they did this. I wish I could do this. I mean, I could probably draw all the art for it, aside from, like, backgrounds and stuff, but, like, I don't have the patience nor the attention span to do so. Also, whenever I start a, like, an, what's it called? Hold on, give me a minute. It's silent. I don't like that it's silent. I don't care that it's snoozed to save memory. I do not care. But
creating your first video, like, you should start with the music. Go to artlist.io and get high quality music and sound effects for any type of video you want to create. For example, let's make it intense.
And then I automatically cannot finish it for some reason. So voice act as much, because while I love voice acting, I don't have much confidence in trying to mimic their voices. The only moment I tried to actually voice act was doing Hikari no, because I know his voice is slightly lower and more chill. So when this game actually comes out and we're live streaming it, I may actually try to genuinely voice act. I also have people in the house, so I try to keep my voice lower because I don't have any, like, sound suppressing foam. I can't remember what it's called. And yeah. But by the time it comes out, I should be able to. Not like I have my own house, but like, because I'll still live with my nanny because I won't have money and crap, but you know. Hopefully, by the time this comes out, both me and my sister will be debuted by then. No, actually, I take that back. She's been on, like, restriction for forever, so I don't think she's getting off anytime soon, but whatever. Moral of the story, I don't know. But when it actually comes out, I hope to actually voice act it, so there's that. And actually try so I can actually practice on voice acting, because it's fun to do. So yeah, and I hope we can see characters like Ivy as her own self entirely, because that would be really cool. As you can tell, I really love Ivy. Ivy, my beloved, who doesn't love Ivy, honestly? And Voxanne. That'd be cool if we could see Voxanne, too. And more of Hikari no, obviously. If we saw him in literally the demo, I have a feeling we're gonna see him a lot in this. If we already have him show up in the demo, depending on choices you make, we might actually be seeing him more. That's just the feeling I'm getting. I still needed to do a go-through of, Darling Pet with, for all the routes and stuff, and, like, stream that crap, dude. Anyways. I just don't know how to stream my phone and this at the same time, so I'll have to figure that out. I don't know how. But yeah. Can't wait. Maybe we'll see some of Lucy, too, and Box. And Rias. And that'd be cool to see some of Rias too, not gonna lie. And Eki, especially Eki, considering it's Ike. What is Ike without Eki, truly? Like, I kind of wonder if the storyline for Ike would also include his denial of Eki existing, and then Ivy's just in the background. He exists! Don't believe him, he exists! He's just refusing to believe it. So I kind of wonder if that'll include, like, his denial of, no, Eki is not a thing, stop trying to make him a thing, when in fact, yes, he is a thing. We all know he's a thing. I also wonder if we'll see Quildren, like, little bitty itty bitty Quildrens. The little Quildren, like, what if we see them and they just whee? Anyways, so, thank you for joining me if you did. That was fun. I also really liked the bop music. And I just realized the background music stopped. How rude, honestly. But anyways, we're ending this anyway, so that's okay. So yeah. Bye-bye. Also, please make sure to check them out on Twitter. And please, if you can, try the game yourself. It's absolutely a bop. Please. I'm going to be doing the survey. This was good. I loved it. But I'm very curious about the voice text thingy, in the settings, voice volume. What do they mean, voice volume? Will there be voice acting? I need to know. I need answers. I must know. Anyways, so, bye. Have a good night, morning, day, whatever the heck time it is for you. It is 8:31 p.m. for me right now, so with that being said, have a good night. So, yeah, not much else I can think of, I don't think. Yeah, just go check it out. It's really good. Love it so much. Literally amazing. Yeah. That's all I can think of. Alright. And one day I'll actually have my own theme music, like, intro and, like, just chatting music as well. One day I'll have that as well. I was asking my sister about that. So, yeah. Also, I made Ivy in Vroid because there is no MMD model for her. I just have to figure out how to, get physics on the model when, like, porting it to MMD. I might just have to look that up, but, like, even looking it up, I am crap at this. once again. No surprise if I have to do that. Anyways, so, yeah. Have a good day, night, whatever the heck. Good night.